In 2018, the government contracted the consortium of Sogea Santom and ETF to rehabilitate the old meter gauge railway northern line from Tororo to Gulu. However, the contractor terminated work recently, citing inconsistencies in payments. Today, the Committee of Government Assurances, chaired by the Kalungu West MP Joseph Seungu, grilled Sogea Santom management on why they abandoned the project with no work done despite receiving payments amounting to 16 million euros from the government.
It is written on 17th May 2022, which is saying no works have been done. So all these payments which they have been receiving, which is equivalent to, this is 6.203948 euros. How did it come? And what was the payment against for?
When they came in, our interest was them giving us information that we were ready to do this work, but the part of government failed to execute A, B, C, D. Here we are, government gave them 14.8 million euros. Now, that's a lot of money. Whether you go to the engineer's language, certificates, and what have you, it is them to provide.
Sogea Santom officials failed to adduce evidence of certificate of completion on which the government based on to pay them over 16 million euros.
We know very well what is done. There are still other certificates that you can be paid in the middle. Even when you have received a certain percent, it doesn't stop the contractor from raising certificates for more payment.
In the letter that you sent us, Mr. Chairman, the only thing we knew you were going to ask us was to discuss the reason for termination of the contract. When we got here, you have given us 13 questions, which I have noted, and that's fair enough. But what we prepared, in our understanding of what this committee wanted to hear from us, is all here.
The 39.33 million euros project to rehabilitate the meter gauge railway from Tororo to Gulu, funded by European Union and the government of Uganda, was meant to start on February 4, 2020 and end on February 9, 2023 under supervision of Uganda Railway Corporation. However, the committee visited the project recently and found that there is barely any work done on the railway route, whose work was initially expected to take 36 months.
Mr. Locus, there is nothing done as per the money paid to these people. Now, these people abandoned the contract and the site, citing irregularities on the side of the contractor. But to our dismay, they are not giving any proof why they left the contract after having got 16 million euros from government.
Paul Villard, the Sogea Santom project manager, labored to explain that they carried out bush clearing on the site, but was ruled out by committee members questioning how site clearance took place in absence of a design.
For example, bush clearing, you don't need a design to clear bush.
And you come to this committee for civil engineer to start telling people that bush clearing doesn't require design, yet you need to survey out and peg out what you are going to do. How can an engineer say it, bush clearing doesn't require design, yet you have to be paid using square meters?
The committee accused the contractor for non-performance, fearing that there must have been connivance with a supervisor in payment of 16 million euros against no certificate of completion.
But who paid the money without certificates of completion? That's the question. The moment you pay, that means you are paying wasteful expenditure as government.
The meeting was cut short after the Sogea Santom official ran short of answers to legislators' questions, and the meeting was rescheduled for next week when the committee expects to meet other government agencies that were in charge of the contract. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.